Hey, I'm here at the 20th annual NAACP Image Awards. I talked to a whole bunch of celebrities. It was an exciting carpet. Let's check out what they had to say.
It's important for me. I can only think back when I won my NAACP Image Awards. I wasn't nominated for an Emmy or anything like that. I had the Kids' Choice Awards, but it felt good to come here to have your own community honor you. So I'd like to do that in return, you know, for these wonderful actors and actresses here, and they are just fantastic. So
getting ready to start filming the fourth season of The Secret Life of the American Teenager.
When was the time when you were like, okay, I have a talent, I want to act?
I actually fell into acting. I started when I was 2. I was discovered, so it was never something that I wanted to do, but it just happened and I love it.
A film that I just did called Jumping the Broom with myself, Angela Bassett, Loretta Devine, Paula Patton. It's an awesome movie. I think it comes out Mother's Day. And then another film me and my sister did called Video Girl, which I produced, and it has Miss Ruby Dee in it, Hailey Duff. I mean, a lot of just really cool people. So yeah, that's what's coming out.
Who's your inspiration?
God, my mom, my sister.
I'm always going to be singing. Music is definitely, you know, in the works. I have been so focused, and I'm one of those people that when I focus on one thing, I want to focus on it wholeheartedly. So in due time, probably in the top of 2011.
And who are you excited to see tonight?
Oh, I'm excited to see everybody. I know Kenny Leon is being honored, and he directed Fences, and I saw Fences on Broadway twice. It was amazing. I know that Ren Brown is here. I know that they're doing snippets of different shows. I'm excited to just see theater in its best, and I think that's important.
I have a new sitcom that's going to be airing on TV1. It's called Love That Girl, executive produced by Martin Lawrence, and it'll be out this winter.
Do you watch your reality shows? How do you feel about them?
I do. I watch The Real Housewives.
Memorable advice that stuck with you?
Memorable advice? I had someone once say, it's not life or death unless it is life or death. So don't take things so seriously.
Any projects you're working on now you could talk about?
Yes. I have a show that launches next Wednesday called Gimme Mo. It's a web series as well as a website and a foundation that I've started. www.gimmemo.com. It's going to be really cool.
The other day we were on, whose show were we on? We had an intervention with Dave and Tamala because they are just a hot mess. In that, they're always doing, you know, Tam's always doing these little jokes insinuating, what we got over there? And saying she's like, hey, daddy, and all these things. And it's like, okay, wait, dad, are you talking about? Because they're married in real life, okay? But they play father and daughter on the show. So there's always some little, you know, odd innuendos kind of flying around, but they are just the most cool people that you have ever worked with in your life. David always has a knack for keeping you on your toes, and he's so talented. So you know what? Every day, I guess you would say, is a bloopers reel, but we have so much fun. And again, we're doing it because all of our fans are supporting us. So thank you, thank you, thank you for that.
I'm excited to kind of see everyone. Last year I went and I thought all the performers were wonderful. I thought all the theater, I don't even know if there's one person that I'm excited to see. I just think the whole show was just fantastic, from all the singers to the dancers, and everybody was so talented.
Now you're on Zane's Sex Chronicles, correct?
Yes, I am.
Tell me about your character.
I play the role of Chanel Wilson. She comes in and she's the temptress for Zane's fiance, and I meet Hunter online, and I give him sort of a, it's an interesting time that we have, and Zane sort of suspects something, so she hires a private investigator to find us, and then we break up very shortly. For all his cheating, for all you cheating men, you will get caught. So we'll see about the third season how that works out.
The Jury is by Gwyneth B. Awesome. She has some great signature pieces. I totally love them. You can make them chic and dress down. It's
Are we going to see another season of The Real McCoy?
Absolutely. Second season coming up soon.
I'm having the time of my life. Action is one of my favorite genres. I've always wanted to do something that was had to do with action. This is the first time I've ever gotten to do it. And also, for the first time, I'm playing the antagonist. Yes, so it's exciting.
I have a film coming out called Muslim, and it's starring myself and Danny Glover and Evan Ross, who's amazing in the film. And it's about a Muslim family and what we go through right after 9/11 and the stereotypes about what Muslim people, who they really are, what they believe in. And I think it's a great project because it's a tiny film. It's really about the message, and it's right on time, considering what's going on in New York and the building of the mosque.
Ashanti's a great writer, actually. I really, really admire her work, so she's a great collaboration. Gosh, who else? Trey Songz, I definitely say. I mean, you got to get that sexy R. Kelly. Got to get that sexy R&B vibe, so.
And to the far right over here, please. Over here, this is it. Thank you.
Tina.
Okay, all of here, please, right in front of us.
Good, right in the center. One more time, in the center.
Back to your right again, too, please. Ashanti, to your right, right here.
You're waiting.
Great.
All right, everyone, that's it. The red carpet is over. I hope you enjoyed what you saw. I am your host, Arista Alana. You're watching Maximo TV.